Hi, everyone, and thank you for watching today's GDL on Google Drive. And today we're announcing two features for the Google Drive SDK. One is a little tiny feature that you might find interesting. The other one that I'm going to spend the most of the time talking about is a really cool feature for helping users discover content that they have in Drive created by your app a lot easier. And this is custom thumbnails. One of the nice things in the Drive UI is the ability to visually navigate your Drive content. This is really important if you're navigating through photos or if you have a lot of content that was very visually focused, charting, presentations, things like that, where seeing an image, representation of that content is a way for users to identify that they're actually using the file that they want. So I actually have up here the Drive UI, and you can see I'm just in list view right now, where all we see is really the title and just the icons for the applications. But when I switch over to grid view, I get this really nice visual representation that I mentioned. So I can see for images, I got a nice little preview. Same for documents and PDFs. But then I have this other doc here, and this is actually a chart that I created with one of the Drive apps, Lucid Chart. And all we can do in this case is just show the icon for the application, right? And as a user, unless I name my files really well, it's not really helpful for me to know if I have a whole folder full of these files, which is one that I really want to work on. And part of the reason why we don't show a thumbnail is, in this particular case, we don't actually have the file content. They're using a feature of the Drive SDK that we call shortcuts, which just allows them to put a pointer to some files that they have stored in their own database. So it'd be great if they could actually upload an image that would help the user, like myself, identify that content quicker. So now we can do that. I'm going to switch over to some code here. This is actually just the Ruby quick start that we did a couple presentations on these a few weeks ago, and I modified this to allow us to upload a thumbnail. This is actually very similar to how an application like Lucid Chart that is using shortcuts would go about creating a document. I'm not going to go through the entire code here, just because we've already been through these before. I just want to focus on the actual changes around inserting the file data. And I've changed a few things here from the quick start, mostly changing the MIME type. This is a MIME type that we use when we're creating a shortcut. And I also inserted some new properties. And these are properties you'll find in the documentation now on the file resource that allow us to upload a thumbnail. In this case, it's really simple. It's thumbnail, and that has two properties in it, an image and a MIME type. Image is a base64 encoded image. In this case, you can see here earlier, we're just reading a thumbnail. It's a PNG file. We base64 encode it, set the MIME type appropriately, and then just execute the request as normal. In this case, because I'm doing a shortcut, I removed the code to do the multi-part or resumable uploads. I'm just putting metadata in there. And life is good. And if this were a real application, we'd also want to do some other things for shortcuts, like uploading indexable text. That way, if somebody's doing a search and there's certain keywords in the content that you think might be helpful for a user to navigate their content, that would make it available to Drive as well. But for here, we're just focusing on thumbnails. And what we're going to do is just run this really quick. Select my account, authorize. And if all goes well, we should have a response back that says it inserted the file. One thing that's really worth noting here is it doesn't actually return the thumbnails. Thumbnails are a write-only property, so you can't read them back. But what we can do now is go back and see the file that we created. And here it is as well. So now when we're in grid view, we actually get the image that we uploaded. This was actually the same Lucid Chart presentation that we just had the icon for before. In this case, I just took the PNG version of that, and I'm using it as a thumbnail. So really easy feature to use for applications that are using shortcuts. This is something that everyone should be doing, particularly if the content that you have has a, you know, a very strong you know, visual representation that's helpful for users. You can think of this in a lot of other contexts too, even in cases where we're storing the content. There are a lot of different formats that applications use that we just simply don't have the capability to generate thumbnails ourselves. You can think of something like an MP3. You might want to do album art as a thumbnail for better visual navigation. You know, for things like, you know, CAD drawings, where again we don't have the logic to render that. You know, the application can do a preview. You know, a very quick rendering of that. Different charting applications with proprietary formats. Really, anything that that you think would be helpful for users to identify that content. Upload them as a thumbnail, along with things like indexable text, so that that content can be, you know, very easily discovered by users. A couple catches with thumbnails, of course. I mentioned already that these are write-only properties, so you can't read back the thumbnail and try to download it. Other than, you just can't. The other thing is that depending on the file type, you do have to be careful about how you maintain the thumbnail images. For shortcuts, maintenance is actually pretty easy, right? Upload the thumbnail, and then whenever there's a significant enough change on your application to that content, just do an update on the metadata to upload a new thumbnail image. With binary content, where we're actually storing the content in Drive, the thumbnail is actually removed in our system every time the content changes. And so it's really important that if you are providing thumbnails, that every time that you change the content for a particular file, that you also upload a new thumbnail for that content. It may be the same thumbnail as you uploaded previously, but it is important to keep making sure that we have an updated copy anytime that content changes. There are some other restrictions in terms of you know, the size of the thumbnail. We do recommend you know, the larger the better. There are different ways that these can get done. If it's too small, you know, you're only going to see a very small image on the screen. But if it's too big, we're going to downsize it anyway. So there's a maximum width of about 1,600 pixels, about 2 megabytes for the image size is about where we'll cap out as well. Most image formats are supported. Generally, we recommend doing formats like PNG, but GIFs and JPEGs are also fine, and other formats will work, but just not recommended. So it's a really easy feature to use. Again, it's a couple extra fields on the file metadata when you're uploading or inserting or modifying a file. Really valuable for users to make the experience of your app and your files just blend in a lot better into Drive. So that's thumbnails. Again, this is just went live today. There's actually a blog post on the Google Apps Developer blog that you can go and read a little bit more, or find this in the documentation that just went live probably about 20 minutes ago. There's one other small feature related to this that I want to point attention to, and this is additional image metadata. We launched probably a month or so back some new properties in the file resource. We have this image media metadata collection on files. And we haven't really done a lot of you know, presentations or talking about this. It's not really featured heavily in the documentation. But for a certain class of applications, these are actually really useful. So previously, we had some very basic information like the width and the height, you know, some geolocation information about that photo. And this is all stuff that's taken from the EXIF data in those images. And this is, you know, pretty useful if you're building a photo browser that's integrating with Drive or any sort of file, you know, media tool. If you're building like a photo library management tool, I would personally love to see somebody build you know, something like an Aperture or a Lightroom that was backed by Drive. I'd probably be the first customer for something like that. But you know, so having width and height is like really useful if you're trying to do screen layout and you want to, you know, basically pre-layout the images while you're loading up the, you know, the thumbnails or you know, the full resolution images asynchronously. But we also just recently exposed a lot more of the metadata, things like the camera make and model, exposure time, aperture, the lens use, focal length, and so on, which is all really useful information that you know, people who are you know, very into their photo editing, you know, may want to, you know, see that information, But we can actually, pre-parse that information for you, so you don't actually need to download the full version of the image, parse it, extract the XF data, in order to display that. So this gives you a way that you can get that information to the user very quickly, just by reading the metadata from the files, while in the background you're loading, either different resolution thumbnails to, progressively load, or, waiting for the full version of that image to load. So not a feature that's useful for all applications, like the thumbnails, but it is something that for a particular class of application that we're seeing a lot more of, which are these photo management apps and image editing tools, this is a great feature to take advantage of. So that's really it for today. We actually do have some other features that we're planning on announcing very soon. So keep tuning into the GDLs, and I think either next week or the week after, there's actually some more parts of this coming along that I think that are even a little bit bigger features. But it's all really cool stuff, and we're really excited to see what people are going to do with this. If you're building an application and you're using shortcuts, jump on the thumbnails right away. If you're using any of these apps for Drive yourself, expect to see developers start to adopt this feature very quickly. That is all for today. As always, you can find us here twice a week and on Stack Overflow, and we're happy to answer whatever questions you have. Great. Thanks.